Welcome back to PRATIK Academy. In previous video, we have seen draft tube theory and different types of draft tubes used in reaction turbines. In this video, we will see cavitation and governings for hydraulic turbines. So let's start. So first, cavitation in turbines. Before going to study what is cavitation, we know that as pressure decreases, then saturation temperature is also decreases. That is, suppose we know that at 1 atmospheric pressure, boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius. Suppose pressure is reduced to 0.5 atmosphere, then boiling point of water will also reduce. Suppose say it will start boiling at 30 degrees Celsius or 25 degrees Celsius when pressure is reduced to 0.5 or below atmospheric pressures. This is the phenomenon. It is, as pressure decreases, corresponding saturation temperature is also decreases. This is the basis for cavitation. Then what is cavitation? Cavitation is the phenomenon of formation, growth and collapse of vapor filled bubbles in flowing fluid due to local fall in pressure is called as cavitation. Okay, that means it consists of formation of bubbles, growth of vapor bubbles and collapse of vapor bubbles in flowing fluid. Okay, so why this cavitation occurs? Cavitation occurs due to fall of pressure below saturation pressure corresponding to surrounding temperature. That is, when turbine is working in working condition, then surrounding temperature is supposed say 25 degrees Celsius and corresponding saturation pressure is say 0.5 bar. Then if within turbine, if pressure is falls below this 0.5 bar, then corresponding saturation temperature will be say 24 degrees Celsius or 23 degrees Celsius, which is below 25 degrees Celsius. Then surrounding temperature is at 25 degrees Celsius, pressure is 0.4 bar, then at this 0.4 bar pressure, temperature of water or surrounding is above saturation temperature, hence water will start boiling and vapors are formed. Okay, these vapors are formed where? Then answer is, where these bubbles are formed, these bubbles or vapors are formed at low pressure regions. That means within turbine, low pressure regions are located at runner outlet and, or we can say it as a draft tube inlet. At these two regions, when pressure is dropped below saturation pressure corresponding to saturation temperature or corresponding to surrounding temperature, then vapor bubbles are formed. This is formation step. Then these bubbles grows on increasing, there is a growth of these bubbles, and when these bubbles are come into high pressure regions, then within bubble pressure is low, surrounding two bubbles pressure is high, so due to pressure difference bubbles get collapses. So this is the collapsing. This is a collapsing of bubbles. When these bubbles are collapses near walls of draft tube, then due to hammering effect of surrounding water on these empty regions or vapor filled regions, the surface of draft tube gets eroded. Okay, and gets rough. So what are the effects of this cavitation? First effect is vibration, because continuous hammering of water present surrounding two vapors, there is a vibration produced. Then second effect is noise. Then erosion of surface due to hammering of water. Then surface roughening. These are the effects of cavitation. Then last question, how to overcome this cavitation? First is by proper selecting of speed of turbine. If speed is very large, then pressure decreases more and there are more chances of cavitation. So we have to maintain or select proper speed of turbine. Then by selecting proper material for draft tube which can withstand this hammering effects of water, which is having high strength materials. Then by keeping runner underwater. Third is by keeping runner underwater, but this is not economical because we have to frequently carry this runner outside of water for maintenance purposes. So therefore last is not economical or feasible. The first two are possible and economical. So this is cavitation. Let's see again. Cavitation arises due to local fall of pressure. Then where it occurs? At low pressure regions, that is draft tube outlet, draft tube inlet or runner outlet. At these regions, as pressure decreases, vapors are formed, bubbles are grows, and when they flows to high pressure regions, then due to pressure differences they get collapses. And when these bubbles collapses near walls of draft tube, then water filled surrounding to these vapor bubbles will try to occupy these empty spaces and strikes on surfaces of draft tube, and therefore erosion of surfaces takes place. Okay, so this is about cavitation. Then next is governing of turbines. So what is governing? Why to carry out governing? As we see in the performance of turbines, we have to maintain speed of rotor constant, because we know that frequency of AC current produced by generator is depending upon speed of rotor. So to maintain constant frequency, we have to maintain speed of rotor constant. So we are governing turbines, that is maintaining speed of turbine or rotor constant. So first is method is using spear rod assembly. This is for Pelton wheel turbine. So this is the schematic diagram for spear rod governing mechanism. It consists of centrifugal governor, which works on centrifugal effect. Then there is a lever which is pivoted on fulcrum. Then control valve is there, which controls oil flow. Then oil pump to carry oil from sump to control valve. Then this is the oil sump for storage of oil. Then spear rod assembly is there. This is the spear rod assembly. This is the nozzle. Then remaining is servo motor or relay valve. This is the servo motor and relay valve. Okay, here as shown in figure, turbine shaft is geared with governor shaft. When turbine is operated at rated speed, both valves are closed and spear rod is arranged in its normal position. Okay, as speed of turbine shaft increases, then this speed is increasing. As turbine shaft is geared with governor shaft, speed of governor is also increasing. When speed of governor increases, then centrifugal force is increasing, and due to centrifugal force, these balls are trying to move outward. These balls are trying to move outwards. One point of this arm is fixed and sleeve is movable in upward direction. Then as balls try to move outward direction, this sleeve is moving in upward direction. Here, when this sleeve is moving in upward direction, lever will move in downward direction. Okay, when lever moves in downward direction, then it opens this V2 valve here, then oil from pump is flows through this V2 valve and pushes this piston to move, or this spear rod to move in forward direction and reducing discharge through nozzle and hence speed. Then this oil is passed through this return valve to oil sump here. In second condition, when turbine shaft is rotated below rated speed, then speed of turbine shaft is also reduced. As this shaft is geared with governor, then speed of governor shaft is also reduced. When speed is reduced, these balls are moves in downward direction again. Okay. When these balls moves in downward direction, sleeve will also move in downward direction here. Where sleeve here moves in downward direction, lever will move here in upward direction. Lever moves in upward direction, it closes this V2 valve and flow from pump is allowed through this V1 valve. When flow is through V1 valve, this V1 oil is move piston in backward direction, allowing more water to flow through nozzle and increases speed to rated value. Then this return oil is passed through return path to oil sump. So this is the governing of turbine. This is for piston wheel turbine by using spear rod assembly. Then second is by using deflector plate. Again, it is for piston wheel turbine. Here rest of arrangement is same. When turbine shaft is moving with high speed, governor will move with high speed. Then due to centrifugal effect, lever here moves in downward direction. When lever moves in downward direction, there is a deflector plate. This deflector plate at normal condition does not oppose flow of water jet, but when this lever moves in downward direction, this lever will try or will make this deflector plate to come in direction or path of this jet and deflects some quantity of water from its normal direction and hence reduces discharge or hence reduces amount of water striking on bucket and hence speed. Okay, so in this way it controls discharge through nozzle and hence speed of turbine. But here lot of water is wastage here, so it is not efficient way. Then next governing method is for Francis and Kaplan turbine. This is using guide blade arrangement. Here you know that in Francis or Kaplan there are guide rings, and on guide rings there are guide blades which are arranged on particular direction and we can control discharge through these guide vanes by controlling openings of these guide vanes. Rest of arrangement is similar, that is of centrifugal governor lever. When speed is more, then oil from control valve tries to push this piston in backward direction. When piston moves in backward direction, it will rotate this deflector plate by some amount, and when this deflector plate deflate from its normal position, it closes opening or it reduces opening through guide vanes and hence conduces discharge. In other way, when oil is coming or oil is trying to push this piston rod in forward direction, then deflator plate deflates in up another position and allows more quantity of water to come inside by increasing space between two guide vanes, so and hence increasing discharge. Thus, by this arrangement, by controlling opening between two guide vanes, we can control discharge, or we can vary which discharge, and hence we can control speed of turbine. Okay, so this is for governing of reaction turbine. So if you like this video, please comment, like and subscribe our channel. Thank you.